Ladies and gentlemen, Eddie Hearn for Matchroom Sport proudly presents 12 rounds of boxing in a final eliminator for the IBF Bantamweight Championship of the World. Ladies and gentlemen, we are sponsored by TitanBet.co.uk, StubHub and Scott's Menswear. And we welcome our viewers joining us live on Sky Sports. You've joined us for the very best ringside seat in the business. And we come to you live from the great city of Leeds. All the officials have been appointed by the IBF and the British Boxing Board of Control. The supervisor from the USA is Lindsay Tucker. Our area representatives are Robin Smith and Alan Allstar. Working the red and blue corners, our inspectors are Chad Godfrey and Barry Coulson. The timekeeper at the bell from the still city of Sheffield is Mr. Barry Pinder. Our three scoring judges from around the world using the 10-point must system. Ladies and gentlemen, firstly, from Las Vegas, USA, Lisa Giampa. From Fleetwood, England, Mr. Steve Gray. And from Mexico City, Mexico, it's Alejandra Lopez. When the bell rings and the action begins, the man in the middle, the man in charge from Doncaster, England, is Mr. Michael Alexander. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the right to fight for the championship of the world, here we go. Introducing to you firstly, fighting out of the red corner wearing the white trunks, trimmed with gold. He weighed in at 8 stone, 5 pounds, 5 ounces with a 30 fight record. 24 wins, 16 inside the scheduled distance. Just 5 defeats and 1 draw. He comes to the ring as the former IBF Super Flyweight Champion of the World from Mexico, Gatito Rodrigo Guerrero. And now, ladies and gentlemen, fighting out of the blue corner wearing the blue trunks, trimmed with yellow and white, weighed in at 8 stone, 4 pounds, 3 ounces, and a 25 fight record. He has 19 wins, 7 inside the scheduled distance, 4 defeats and 2 draws. The holder of the coveted Lord Lonsdale's Challenge Belt and the Commonwealth Championship, ladies and gentlemen, he is the former IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World from Darlington, England, it's Stewie. We'll fight for the World Championship. Here we go, 12 rounds of boxing in our final eliminator for the IBF Bantamweight Championship of the World.
Well, as you both know the rules, so let's just have a good clean fight, okay? Most of all, meant to defend yourselves at all times. Touch gloves.
A crucial crunch clash here. An eliminator for the IBF Bantamweight title, for Lee Haskins Crown, the IBF's number 3 and number 4, two quality operators in England's Stewart or Stewie Hall and Mexico's Rodrigo Gato Guerrero. It's a proper old-fashioned match with high stakes, Glenn.
Yeah, it really is, and Stewie desperate to get back in the world title contention and get that championship back. But this is a tough fight. Guerrero's good credentials, but Stewie's come out purposeful, get center ring and get on the front foot.
He's won 19 of 25, Stewart Hall. Guerrero 24 of 30, and so much around elite level over the last part of his career. He's also just 28 still. How much fire in the belly for Guerrero. Hall has the home advantage. Yes, this is Josh Warrington territory, but he's a friend of Warrington's. And you heard with the announcements, the crowd really getting behind Hall. Both former world champions, both want to reign again.
Yeah, well, he's already won his world title here once before, beating Wisi Malinga in this very arena. So, you know, he'll feel comfortable here.
Happy memories of this venue. And a feel-good story for Stuart Hall. Hasn't all gone so well since then. But he's got himself back together and he's relocated to Birmingham under the watchful eye of the excellent veteran trainer Paddy Lynch and Max McCracken. And he saw him hug Frankie Gavin and Cal and Gamal Yafai, who he's been sparring with in preparation. He says he feels as good as ever and that age is no barrier. He looks good.
Yeah, he's getting off to the better start. He looks bigger, he looks stronger, looks very, very determined, doesn't he?
That's what he always has had, Glenn, that steely determination.
Yeah, and that takes some beating when he's really pushing forward on the march. He's a terrific fighter, Stewie.
Guerrero looking for the long right hand, but walks into one there. Defense loose, left hand low, made to pay.
Well, Guerrero's been very relaxed, a little bit sloppy, if I could say, in this opening session. Hasn't looked sharp at all. Has to take another good jab from Hall.
Yeah, very good jabs from Stuart Hall, who's got hold of the center of the ring. Just a languid look to Guerrero early, but it is so early. Excellent start, though, from Stuart Hall in fight number 26.
Give us a bucket to spit in.
Plenty of experience in that blue corner. Paddy Lynch and Max McCracken there as well. Good fighter he was. He was part of Anthony Joshua's corner last week in the O2. So plenty of advice for Stuart Hall. Probably didn't need much after that first round.
No, he settled in very well early on. Good start.
Yep, the authoritative jab of Stuart Hall from Darlington. In with Rodrigo Guerrero from Mexico City. So many great fighters, of course, down the years. Tough and real fabulous list from Mexico. How good is Guerrero at this stage of his career? He switches to southpaw. He can do that. He can box a session orthodox, a session southpaw. Stuart Hall sticking to his plan. He's a very orthodox, tight and straight fighter, isn't he, Glenn?
Yeah, he is. Keeps his hands nice and high. There's nothing pretty about what Stewie Hall does. He's just very effective. You know, he doesn't make many mistakes. Guerrero looks loose. Doesn't look as if he's settled yet, and get caught with three good shots there from Hall.
Breaking through the defense, but the body shots of Guerrero. Just complain one was low there, but there is some reddening around that area of Hall. Maybe he feels at 36 he can damage the body. Guerrero, part of the tactics, brought a big team over. They've been here for a week. They've said all the right things. The ambition is there, but Stuart Hall just sharper with some of these early shots. Yeah, and exchanges.
Guerrero is quite open, isn't he? You know, he hasn't really settled in his defense, his lax, and Stewie getting right through the middle with some good, solid punches.
Just five through the years, Guerrero drawn one. Can punch those 16 knockouts in 24 victories, so Hall does have to be careful, but it is Hall who is landing the eye-catching punches, and he's always had a pretty good chin too, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's tough as they come, Stewie. But very strong mentally. And, you know, he's looking so determined at the minute. He's getting off with his punches first. They both connect in that exchange.
He's not quite landing his jab from that southpaw style. Guerrero.
Guerrero looks like one of those fighters who's prepared to take a couple to get his own shot on, but he's fallen short.
He is a Mexican.
Yeah.
Lucky enough, remembering those 25 years, see the likes of Marco Antonio Barrera, Eric Morales, Juan Manuel Marquez, so many of the lighter weights. So tough, determined, skillful, and they can adapt as well in the ring. Darlington Stuart Hall, who desperately wants a rematch with Lee Haskins, who holds the IBF bantamweight title. Had to take a couple of body shots there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did, but he took them well enough, but come back with a cleaner shot. Round three.
Rodrigo Guerrero in the white trunks with the gold lettering and the white and gold boots. Again, electing the southpaw stance in this, the third round, the fluorescent boots of Stuart Hall. And just complaining about a clash of heads. Guerrero. And he's annoyed at that. Referee Michael Alexander giving him time. And he mentally didn't seem to take that too well, Glenn.
No, he didn't. I'm surprised to see him complaining as much. Didn't seem happy at all. But to be honest, he hasn't had a happy start, has he? He's running into shots. Stewie with his straight punches has landed very cleanly. And now there's some damage from that clash of heads.
Yep, the blood flows now. And that will buoy Stuart Hall on even more. Nothing pretty about what Hall does, really. It's just effective. He's compact, he's tight, he's organized. And at the moment, Guerrero's not. That's the big difference. He's just rushing in almost without any sort of plan.
Yeah, and he used his head there, Guerrero, trying to...
He's not happy one little bit about that head clash. And
it's not often you see tough, rugged Mexicans making as much as he is of that clash of heads. You know, it was accidental. He come off the worst. That's boxing.
This is a guy that's been 12 rounds plenty of times. He showed courage and heart. And at the moment, we don't know quite what's in front of us. He's won his last five. Guerrero gets a cheer from his corner as he puts some of these shots together.
Yeah, good little spell for Guerrero, but that takes a left hook, and he's...
Again, he's complaining, the gun shield's loose. And Stuart Hall's going to jump on him here. And Guerrero, well, he's just in danger of falling apart mentally here. Very strange start, this, from Guerrero. Targeting the body, trying to come out with crosses. Is there a cut by the eye as well? There is, and he's going for it. Maybe he believes he's got to win by knockout over here in Britain, and he's firing shots in to the body and really biting down on that gun shield, but Stuart Hall catches it with a clean shot. Great action here, really hotting up in the third round.
Yeah, he means business, doesn't he, Guerrero, having a good spell in the fight. That's 25 seconds of this round, and he's come on strong, but Hall comes straight back at him.
Tucked up Hall, back he comes. Not a dynamite puncher, seven knockouts through his career, Stuart Hall. More power you feel with Guerrero, but he's open, the Mexican, wild and woolly that third. And they're complaining about the cut to the eye. There was blood from the other head clash as well. There were two of them.
Yep, come off the worst there. But nothing intentional in that. He's going for a body shot, Hall. And it was a decent combination. He was trying to get on. And there, Guerrero just trying to retaliate a little bit. But it was good left hook left from hook, Hall yes. that caused the cut to the left eye, and he complained.
To a head, clash and a punch.
He just looked a bit all at sea, but he drove himself on, didn't he, with those combinations, Rodrigo Guerrero.
The Mexican fire. Michael Alexander just halting proceedings, and the doctor's going to come in and have a look at the cut. His body language isn't good, Guerrero. The corner of the eye. Find a carry on, the gumshoe goes back in. And he looks at his corner. It's a real question about his mental stature now, Glenn. Guerrero.
Yeah, he's upset, but he's now looking to attack and come for punches, but walks straight onto a right hand, and that's just the good boxing. He wastes nothing, Stewie Hall, and he's doing great so far in this fight.
He's finding that right hand as well as Guerrero charges forward and continues to chip away to the body. And again, there's the right hand, just the accuracy of Hall as the cut bleeds from Guerrero. It's making for a good fight, though.
A very good fight. Really is hotting up now as Guerrero is angry and he's trying to take the fight to Hall, but Hall keeping his head, and that's the secret. Just to carry on with that good jab, and the right hand takes one from Guerrero.
Yep, swung one around there, didn't he? The man that went the distance with Daiki Kameda and Juan Carlos Sanchez, Raul Martinez, Victor Chinian, who beat him. But that's good form. And again, the body shots. And now he is following the tactics downstairs to open Hall up and tire him.
Yeah, he's had better work in this round, Guerrero, with the body punches. But Hall not unraveling, looking to pick his own shots to the body there.
He's answering, isn't he, Stuart Hall? When he's under fire, he's waiting, he's taking a couple, good defense there, and then he comes back with something.
Yeah, he's keeping his head, and I think that's what it's all about. You know, he's a calm guy, Hall. But Guerrero's good pressure from him and good body punches, just closing the distance down. Hall needs to use that jab to better effect.
Left hook to the body as well. This is a better round for Guerrero, despite the worry at the start of it when the doctor looked at his eye. It was all in danger of going badly wrong for the Mexican.
Well, I think that was the reason why he's pushed it forward that much, just in case he doesn't know what it's like, in case he thinks it's that bad. He's really going for it now.
Well, he's got to get through to the end of the round, doesn't he? Otherwise, before the end of four, a head clash would be a technical draw, but the eye was caused by a punch, and that would make it very different. And Guerrero with a right hand and tries the body shot again. He's won this round, the Mexican, no question about that. Paul has had to take plenty. Welcome back. It was a good round by Rodrigo Guerrero. He needed it, Johnny.
Keep an eye on this pace. His pace is everything, because Guerrero started pretty slow, pretty leaky, but now he's started to try and walk Hall down. Hall's getting a little bit of success, but now the pace is going to make all the difference. A 12-round fight, remember.
They both have so much experience over the 12-round distance. As Glenn was saying earlier, this is where Stuart Hall won the IBF bantamweight title against Vusi Malinga, this very arena. He went 12 with Lee Haskins, Jamie McDonald, Josh Whale, Paul Butler and Randy Caballero. So all signs that it will be a long affair. But those body shots just seemed, I don't know whether to trouble him, but to slow him, Stuart Hall, and he was just digging those elbows in a little bit tighter at the end of that last round.
Yeah, he was, but he knew that Guerrero was making a big push forward, so he didn't sort of go with him. He just bided his time, tucked up, took what he had to. And then now it's really about getting back on his jab, but he seems as if he feels he can overpower the Mexican.
Yeah, his jab was working beautifully, wasn't it? First couple of rounds, all that right hand, pretty sweet too. But when that Guerrero gets in close and unloads these shots to the body, thought about going orthodox, but he's stuck with the southpaw style, and a right hand gets through. And Hall just a bit more open and loose himself.
Yeah, he's just standing right in front of Guerrero, and that's helping the Mexican. He's getting his shots off, but I feel Hall feels he can stand with him. I don't think, you know, he feels that there's any doubt about his own physical strength. He said to me he's in great, great shape, and he's coming out here with a little bit more Hall.
Trading body shots. Remember, Hall hasn't made the weight since October 2014. He weighed in at 8.43, but he was 8.10 when he beat Edwin Tellez, 8.8 against Arnaldo Solano, and 8.9 last time out against Elvis Guillen. Those extra few pounds, how strong is he going to be as the fight progresses? And these body shots are really reining in, and I tell you what, he's answering some questions mentally, and they're both going for it now in this, the fifth round.
Well, terrific scrap, isn't it? Guerrero non-stop punching side to side, but Hall coming back with some eye-catching shots of his own. A good right hand there.
Yeah, lovely shot there. That'll give him confidence. But they have been trading leather aplenty in the fifth here.
Yep, Guerrero's work rate slightly better in this round, but Hall has caught him with some eye-catching punches.
Developing into a really good affair, this one. Antonio Jimenez, David Hamasio, Aaron Silva, and plenty of others around ringside, pointing Rodrigo Guerrero on. And Johnny, I tell you what, he's enjoying this trench warfare, isn't he, the Mexican?
It's perfect, that's exactly what he wants. He's got to talk Stu Hall into his type of fight, and this is what he does. Good, has a war, has a toe-to-toe, and he's hoping a 36-year-old Stuart Hall cannot keep this pace up.
How are you scoring it at the moment?
I've got Stuart Hall up by one.
Yeah, similar, 3-2. Guerrero the last couple of rounds, but not by a lot the last couple of rounds. Hall was still very much in it, but just not landing quite as many punches as Guerrero. But some of the eye-catching punches came from Hall, like that combination there.
Three judges at ringside for this eliminator for the IBF bantamweight title. Steve Gray from Britain, of course, Alejandro Lopez from Mexico, and just in front of us, Lisa Giampa has made the trip over from Vegas. Wonder how they're seeing things. Hall with the better start to the fight, no question about that, but Guerrero has done plenty of work in the last 5 or 6 minutes. Seems to be the sharper shooter, Hall, but maybe the volume, the tenacity, yeah, with, yeah, Guerrero.
Well, that's what it is. There's four punches, then Hall back with three. That was a good spell there. He still looks sharp and fast, Hall, though, although Guerrero is working hard and, you know, doing a little bit more inside, and his work's a bit ragged.
Hall goes downstairs, told to keep them up by Michael Alexander. That right hand is getting through the southpaw guard of Guerrero, but Guerrero again charges forward. And still side to side, but mostly taken on the elbows and gloves by Hall, who is under pressure though.
Yeah, in his fight with Paul Butler, he was just outworked a little bit in that fight. It was close.
It was, wasn't it? Good fight.
It was a good fight. It was close, but, you know, he came on stronger towards the end.
Whipped in a body shot there, Hall, with a left hook, followed it up with a right hand. Just Guerrero just seemed to just stop momentarily, but back he comes. They are so hard, of course, the Mexicans.
County Durham lads on by the end of it.
I thought you might say that.
It's kind of the Mexico of Britain.
Yeah, he's in terrific shape, isn't he, Stuart Hall? And it's a great story, the way he turned his life around, and boxing helped him. Really did, didn't it?
Oh, brilliant. It's, you know, it's an inspiration what he did with his life, and now, you know, lovely family. He's got a newborn son, Jax. His name's on his belt. Big family man, Stewie.
What about that one, that round? Close?
Yeah, for me, that's the closest one so far. Difficult to split them, even sort of round, both having their successes. Stewie's covering up a lot of these body shots, but he's allowing Guerrero just to work away, and that's catching the eye. You know, that's getting through still, but then comes back with a nice little short left hook of his own.
Second half of this fascinating, compelling bantamweight match. Just wipe away the grease from the cut there, which fortunately is held up for Rodrigo Guerrero. And that's what we want to see. Tight affair, as your card suggests.
Yeah, all still in a lead, cleaner punches, but I'd like to see him just use his jab a little bit more and just busy up with his punches. As I said, he let it slip very marginally against Paul Butler, where it took him a while to get going in that fight, but that's what Stewie's like, you know. He'll come on stronger and stronger and stronger.
But maybe back to the jab, to those orthodox skills that saw him get to the English ABA bantamweight final. Spennymoor, wasn't he, with good amateur?
Yeah, but I think, you know, his main strength is his determination. So he's got good boxing skills. What he does is basic, but it's good, you know, and that gets you a long, long way, as it has with Hall.
Still light on his feet, Guerrero. Looking to come forward. How many more tricks does he possess? What else is in the locker? How hard will he have trained? Because, you know, Hall would have whipped himself into shape away from the family. As the atmosphere begins to build ahead of the Leeds hero, Josh Warrington's return to the ring. Good work by Stuart Hall, and they'll be beginning to get behind him too, as the two fighters in there go toe-to-toe. Really good action here, and it's becoming pretty hot.
It really is. Guerrero working hard. Stewie comes back with a long right hand. But this is pivotal rounds. Very important who can get these. They're both fighting really hard. Not a lot to separate them. Guerrero just getting off with more shots, taking the eye a little bit. And
yeah, that's,
Stewie's got to do something different there.
Back comes Hall. Right hand and body shots needed to respond. Guerrero digging in. And a right hand again. He just seems to find an answer when he needs to, Stuart Hall, despite the volume from Guerrero, who keeps whipping in these body shots, and it's becoming grueling already. And we've got so long to go.
Little flurry inside from Guerrero, who's coming back with some shots of his own. But there's the bit of the strength of Hall. Guerrero straight back in with his head.
It's a really hard-fought, competitive and highly entertaining fight, this. And it should be between two of the best in the world.
Yeah, I mean, these are the two best in the IBF, the two contenders fighting it out for who gets the title, who fights for title shot.
Just a big gulp of air from Stuart Hall. Guerrero, for me, that round. What about you two?
Yeah, Guerrero, for me, just because he's working a little bit harder. Stewie had the best combination of the round. Hall, you know, threw three, four good shots there. But for the, you know, he's just allowing Guerrero just to keep busier on the inside. And, you know, he needs to start doing a little bit more.
The last two rounds have been very, very tight for me. I like how Stuart Hall managed to slip back a little bit and managed to get the distance on his jab, but the Guerrero's work rate when he stands square on and drops those body shots in, that's what pulls him back in the round.
What will the corners be telling them, Johnny, at the moment, or what should they be saying?
Keep the pressure on, keep the pressure on. They're looking to see whose heart is going to break first, and that's what it's all about. Stuart Hall's fitness is second to none. You can see how his body's cut. But Guerrero, this is his style of fight. This is what he wants. He doesn't want a boxing match. He wants a tear-up.
As you say that, he's gone on the back foot, Guerrero, at the beginning of this eighth round. Hall back in the middle of the ring. Where is that jab that was really effective early? Who will feel the pace more? Good combination there and out.
Well, you know, I'd put my money on Stewie Hall in the later rounds to come on stronger and stronger, because that's what he does. Terrific engine in him. And Guerrero, you know, he's got that leaky defense. Although he can work well inside, when he does get hit, it's quite dramatic, isn't it, when Hall gets through with good punches.
There's the jab again. Welcome back. That shot, potent from Hall. And the following right hand, finding accuracy when he needs it. Will he be catching the eye of the three judges? Most people at ringside, just gauging opinion, have got it very, very close. Around one way or the other, or even level. It's all to fight for.
Yeah, but I think it's really important for Paul to keep the punches, straight. Guerrero sets himself when he goes to throw a hook. So I think Hall's got to keep a bit of distance between the two of them and keep things straight.
Burst there from Guerrero. Right hand got through, but Hall came back. Tit for tat. Styles gelling well. And despite the head clash and the problems, and it looked like, you know, we might have an early finish and one we wouldn't have wanted, because this is great.
Yeah, excellent fight. Good left hook there in that combination. This is better from Hall, who's looking to leave a little bit of distance between the two of them, get his boxing going, and that's where he's better.
Rodrigo Guerrero swinging one in there, but Hall already proving at 36, and despite not having had a title fight for a while, that he has got still plenty to offer at this level.
Yeah, he's not a, you know, unknown person. He's not a person that cut corners. Took a right hand there, though. Needs to keep that left hand up.
He was just dabbing away as well at the left eye. Not sure there's any damage, but something just bothered him. And I think Guerrero smelt that, because he landed a right hook. Out of range there, and Hall responds. Right hand, though, from Guerrero.
Tit-for-tat, isn't it? A lot of this. One lands, then the other lands.
Yeah, hard to score. It really is.
There's the right hand. Nice punch landing from Guerrero, but both of them had their successes in that round. For me, Hall had a few more of the eye-catching punches. It suited him to give a little bit of distance between the two, and I think that's where he can get his better work off. He's got to try and get Guerrero when he sets himself to throw a punch, because he telegraphed it a little bit, and that's where Paul's got to use his height and reach.
It's only a break when you play
Box against you. Box, Once again, keep boxing. Good advice from Paddy Lynch, who's seen it all before. As we enter round number 9, this is the 199th of Stuart Hall's career that started in 2008, and the 200th for Rodrigo Guerrero, who began 3 years earlier in 2005. Who's been in the tougher fights through their career? Who has that extra bit down the stretch in these championship rounds? The engine and, of course, the desire. Both seem to want this hugely, yeah. And that's great to see.
Hall will tell you, he hasn't had a tough career. He still feels fresh. That's how, you know, he can still do it at 36 and still be in really, really good shape. Because he doesn't feel, you know, he hasn't had a great deal of fights, and he doesn't feel that he's really had a lot of hard fights.
Shinsuke Yamanaka, probably number one in the world. Jamie McDonnell, of course, who retained his belt on the big O2 show last week. Juan Carlos Payana, Anselmo Moreno, Tomoki Kamida, who McDonnell beat a couple of times. Lee Haskin about 7, Rodrigo Guerrero, Stuart Hall. It's a good mix in this fiery 8-stone-6 division, and this is a good fight.
Yeah, terrific fight. Still all to fight for. Nobody's really took over control in this fight yet.
And what you often see with a little guy is work rate and tenacity. And plenty of shots and brave hearts. And high skills too.
But it's all who's showing the boxing skills. I think boxing is the key here. You know, he can box. He's moving well here, and he's catching Guerrero with jabs.
And tucking those elbows in again when it matters. Guerrero hunting, but not landing as much. Still fiery, though.
Yeah, still looking to land the body punches. He's warmed up through this as well, hasn't he? Not a particularly great start for Guerrero, but he has warmed into this.
Yeah, you wonder if the couple of rounds that Guerrero spent sulking about the cut and complaining and almost showing out could come back to haunt him. We don't know how the three judges are seeing that. Remember, one from Mexico, from Guerrero's home, one from Britain and one from America. Remember that draw was, I think, what, 22-1 beforehand? The bookies couldn't split them on who would win, but would you have Hall probably a favourite now?
Yeah, I've got him, you know, slightly the favourite, but it's really down to the tactics of the fight now. If he gets drawn in like he is a little bit towards the end of this round, then Guerrero starts to look like he's doing that little bit more, but Hall better at long range.
Tight, tight, close. Ebbing and flowing rounds of action, Johnny Nelson. A really good watch, isn't it?
A really good watch. This is so even. I just think over the last couple of rounds, Guerrero's starting to just edge it. That's my personal opinion, but I think the better boxing, of course, from Hall when he has to do it. But this is more comfortable for Guerrero as they both get tired, as they both become more flat-footed, because then he has a target to hit. Hall has to be on the back foot and punch his way out of pressure. And that's what Guerrero's trying to do, put him under pressure, make him work off the back foot. When he does it, when he boxes well, he boxes final, snap the jabs in. But this is what Guerrero needs him to do, stay flat-footed and war with him. And that's why he managed to drag the rounds back.
Yeah, I think Paul knows how to win this, and it's with boxing, with range, but he's got to keep the work rate up. Very important.
9 minutes to go. This eliminator for the IBF bantamweight title. It's the hors d'oeuvre, really, before Josh Warrington's big test. But what an hors d'oeuvre it is. Level on Glenn's card. And Johnny's?
I've got him up two. I've got Guerrero up 2 rounds, I'm afraid.
Very, very interesting what happens next. Guerrero's done 12 rounds 7 times. Hall's done it 7 times. Again, he complains about a head clash. He doesn't want to mess around with that, does he?
Heads clash together. I mean, it's just, you know, it's just the styles of the fighters. There's nothing malicious in there. The heads clashed, and then Hall landed a decent right hand. Good right hand again from Hall. He can box really well when he wants to. And that's what I think he's got to concentrate on. Just keep the distance. Don't let Guerra get the body punches on.
He'd admitted himself that he's been an overachiever, Stuart Hall. He was happy just to win a British title, which he did on a hot night back in 2010 in Peterlee against Ian Knapp. He defended against Martin Power, Gary Davis, John Donnelly. Yes, he lost to Jamie McDonnell and Lee Haskins, but he then went on to become a world champion. It's been a fabulous story. Will it carry on here? On the evidence of what we've seen over the course of this, he belongs in this class.
Yeah, he certainly does. And he may say he's an overachiever, but I tell you what, he's a very, very competitive person. Paul plays a mean game of golf as well.
doesn't give you any
shots there either.
Good right hand from Hall. The hustle and bustle and aggression of Guerrero, though. Will the judges favour that? Well, the cleaner shots at Timer Hall again. One right in the eye, and he looks in his corner and he's complaining bitterly again. Guerrero, come on, he says. Watch the head, says Michael Alexander. We saw Eric Hunter complain against Lee Selby, didn't we, last week a fair bit.
Yeah, well, he's complained an awful lot, and that to his detriment. You know, this is what happens in boxing. You know, he's the shorter man.
Is it overuse of the head by Hall, or as you said,
no,
is it a clash of styles?
I don't think so. You know, Hall, if Guerrero comes in, he's going to dip his head forward. You know, nothing intentional, but that's good.
Good shots from Stuart Hall. One was in the eye, and one really hurt him as well. And Guerrero's got 40 seconds left in the tip to get himself back together. And he does with a right hand. Real spirit from the Mexican here in Leeds. He looked like he might have been on the way out there.
He did. He looked a bit, didn't he? He looked just tired. He just seemed to sag. That was good from Hall. Another big right hand from Hall crashes in. This is good finish to the round.
Digging his toes in the canvas, Stuart Hall looking for a big right hand to try and wobble Guerrero again. But Guerrero walks through the punches, and look at him come on. What a great round.
Yeah, round for me, but Stuart Hall. That was a really tough round for both men, but just towards the end, it was Hall that came through it the better, and he just sagged a little bit. There's the clash ahead. You know, I mean, it's just the styles of the fighters. Nobody is, you know, he's not dipping his head in or doing anything to pull his head forward. You know, that's just unfortunate.
Psychological breakthrough for Hall, question mark, Johnny.
Without a doubt, what a way to turn around. How he put the shots out, how he dragged the long shots from such a short distance. Excellent.
Come on, mate, let's go, come on.
Really being G'd up by his corner here, Stuart Hall, who drove himself through in a very effective 10th round. And there's just a lethargic look about Rodrigo Guerrero. A bit tired. Is he feeling sorry for himself? The eyes, the complaints. He's given it everything, and he's not made a major dent in Stuart Hall.
No, he hasn't. And Hall, whenever Guerrero gets a few punches on, just comes back with something eye-catching. And I just feel that he's a stronger, sharper man at this point in the fight. This is his time in the fight, Paul.
I know he so desperately wants that rematch with Lee Haskins, who he doesn't particularly have a lot of time for. Good mates with Jamie McDonnell, of course, and they could fight again. There's matchups ahead for Stuart Hall. And that's a good right hand, and he's finishing well here. He started effectively, and at the back end, he's proving his worth here, Stuart Hall.
Yeah, he just looks as if he's mentally, his mind's clear. He knows what he's doing. He's got a game plan. He's coming on stronger here at the end. He looks the fresher of the two.
both whipping in body shots. The accuracy back with Hall, the organisation. More control from Hall, more ragged from Guerrero.
Just got to be a little careful as he tires, he doesn't drop in a bit with that head, Hall, because the referee has warned him a couple of times for that. He cannot afford a point at this late stage to lose one.
Guerrero gets through with a couple. Again, he shouts away at the body, and he puts a combination in. He's finding the energy. He's digging deep in those Mexican boots here. Yeah. It's a good drive from Guerrero.
Yeah, it was a nice little spell from Guerrero, but Hall's still tucking off. He's still taking a lot of them on the arms. They're all not getting through, but Hall needs a good finish to this round after a good start.
Inside the last minute of the 11th. And it's been a really engaging, this battle at bantamweight.
Good shot.
Hall. Good shots, and just gets his defence in. For me, it's been a bit tighter, the Hall defence.
Yeah,
open at times, Guerrero, and will that be the difference on the cards?
Guerrero's looking, he's just trying to throw them punches out. They're not sharp. A lot of them are not landing. But Hall is getting the effective ones on.
Yeah, now he's having a real warning. Don't do it. He'll get a point taken off next time, I think. I think that's the last one that Michael Alexander wants to see. The gum shield out of Guerrero. Back to battle. And in they go again. Left hook from Hall and a right hand. The sweeter shots coming from the British fighter at this stage. The volume might be from Guerrero, but the scoring punches here for Hall.
Well, that was a very important round, I felt, for Stuart Hall. He needed that one, and he got it on my court.
Glenn's got Stuart Hall up. Johnny?
I've got it even. I think it's all on this last round, and that will determine whose next step is for the world title. I think both fighters have given it all. Stuart Hall has come in, he's come on leaps and bounds in the last few rounds, and to me, I think he's drawn it back. A perfect match at this stage.
Some people have got Hall a fair bit in front. It's really what you like again. We've had some really close affairs lately, haven't we? Like the Cardle and Dodd one, and Fielding with Brasselli. It's bit they're hard, it's subjective, and ultimately it's down to the three judges. And that's why, Glenn, we have three. In the old British rules, it was just the referee.
Yeah.
But it's three, and they should get it right.
That's right, they should. But still, I'd like to see Hall have a big, big left round.
Respect between the pair, and why not? This has been fabulous. We see many great battles through those 25 years on Sky Sports. This might not be an epic, but I tell you what, it's a really good one. One of the best ones we've seen so far this year.
Oh, a terrific fight there. It's absolutely wonderful. Paul, always entertaining, always gives his all. Guerra played his part, still is, still trying to get them punches off. But for me, just the cleaner punches, the sharper punches, the ones that are counting are from Hall. But he needs to finish well.
Glances in his corner, Guerrero knows he needs a big finish. He is away from home, remember, too. Will that matter? There is a Mexican judge, of course, as the eye opens again. You can't question either of these energy levels, spirit, competitiveness, stubbornness, and skill in there too.
No, neither one of these boys wants to lose. It means a lot to both of them. A shot at the world title. Who can just drive through to the finish, the better. It's always his sort of fight at the end of the fight, Hall.
Good combinations for Guerrero. Nice right hand as well. And back in he goes. A minute 30 to go. Of this terrific battle, right hand from Hall, as Cagliari raises his fist at ringside to his friend.
Yep, Guerrero has had a determined effort in this last round.
But I tell you what, Glenn, we'd see this again for a world title.
I'm not sure they want to see it again, though, do they? Let's get this one over with first, they're saying.
A draining, grueling fight enters the last 50 seconds. No knockdowns, no points off, just the cut. But what a pace it's been fought at. Two excellent men giving it their all. And what boxing is all about.
Well, it has been difficult to score because Guerra has pummeled away inside, throwing shots, but the better, cleaner, more accurate punches, eye-catching punches, have come from Hall. But look at Guerra. You know, you've got to give him points when he's getting through and the work rate.
He's digging in deeper here, Guerra, in this last round, and a good right hand.
Yeah, he's done more in the last round, Guerra. Could this be a very, very important round?
Hall hurling out body shots. Back come Guerra. The bell's going to come any second. They both have given everything, and they fall into each other's arms. Stuart Hall, Rodrigo Guerra, fair play, terrific fight, and applause all round for the efforts that both fighters, both teams, put into it. It was a world-class affair. Who's going to get it?
Well, that was a really hard-fought fight, wasn't it? Some good work from both men. You could tell how important it was to them. But very, very close. I've got Hall just edging it out. Guerra, for me, won the last round. But Hall, cleaner punches, just did a bit more.
A terrific tussle. And people at ringside, you know, really are split. Johnny, you've got it for Rodrigo.
You know what, I Guerra. Said the last round, you'd have to give it to, it was all on the last round, and Guerra got the last round. Don't be surprised if we see a draw here tonight, that means we get it again, but I think Guerra gets it by one round.
Yeah, for me, it's Hall. I think cleaner punches, better punches. I think Guerra did terrifically well and kept throwing lots of punches, but Hall was tucking up. For me, just did a bit more.
Hall has his arms aloft. Will we have a split? Will we have a draw? Or will the judges see it one-sided? I don't think so. I think it's going to be close, Johnny.
This was a match made in heaven. I think this fight wouldn't have been as exciting if it wasn't for each fighter. They matched perfectly. I think Stuart Hall's determination, Guerrero's wanted to stand there and have a toe-to-toe.
Hall put his arms up, but neither man is celebrating. They're probably exhausted with the amount of effort and energy they put into that, which was terrific. I say, whichever way it goes, I want to see a rematch, even if the fighters, Glenn, don't.
Yeah, well, there might just be a rematch if it is a draw. Might, you know, certainly the crowd wouldn't mind seeing it again. It's been a very good, hard-fought fight. Two world-class operators.
I think John McDonald has got the scores ready. Who has won it and will go through towards a world title tilt again?
Ladies and gentlemen, the three scoring judges. All three judges have scored this contest 117-111 by unanimous decision. The winner of this final IBF eliminator goes to England's Stuart Hall!
Wow, all three judges have it by six rounds to Stuart Hall. Eddie Hearn was looking out the ring as though he wasn't sure he was going to get it. Johnny, you gave it to Guerra. Glenn, just to Stuart Hall. And the judges had it one-sided.
Oh, my goodness. I did not see that coming. I'd have even leant towards a draw, but no way was it that wide.
Cleaner work, the punches, the eye-catching ones, despite the work rate of Guerra, they went for the accuracy.
I think the judges have looked and said that a lot of those shots were hitting Hall on the arms and gloves and shoulders and that, and weren't getting through. He did have the cleaner punches, he did have the better punches, and for me he was the winner, but that is a little wider than I thought.
I think that's unfair on Rodrigo Guerra, what he put into the fight. But Stuart Hall, a delighted man. His whole career really was on the line again tonight. but he proved how much he's got left in the tank. And he will fight for a world title again. He's with Andy.
Stewie, brilliant action. Tell us what it means to be involved and win a fight like that.
Means everything. That last round, I was lucky to stand up. He hurt me with some body shots. Honestly, I couldn't breathe, but fair play to him. I'm still hurting off the body shots now from the last round, but I thought I did enough early on. He come back in the fight, and it was a great win. I just want to thank my trainer, Paddy, for coming out of retirement for this, and Max and Des. Absolute great team. I've got a proper team now. I've been away in camp for 11 weeks. I want to thank all my sponsors and dedicate that to my nana. She just passed away long ago. And thanks to Coral, who looked after me, kept my body in shape.
IBF mandatory for Lee Haskins' title. Will you be cheering him on next month and chase a rematch for that?
Yeah, definitely. I want Lee to win. He's from England. You know what I mean? He's an awkward fighter. I fought him 4.5 years ago, but I think I'm a different fighter now. He might watch that and think, oh, it's an easy fight. But listen, that was my world title fight there. I thought, I'll come through that. Lee, I'm coming for you.
Could you have made it easier on yourself, though, by not getting involved in his sort of fight?
Yeah, my trainer, he told me the game plan was boxing, but everyone knows I like a brawl, and he was shouting at me in the corner, stop getting involved, but
he fought with his heart instead of his head.
It was great to watch, though. Quick word with promoter Eddie Hearn. What a fight that was.
Unbelievable. Massive respect to both guys. I don't think the judges gave enough credit to Guerrero. I had that just for Stewie, one or two rounds. But a great fight. Massive credit to both guys. And he'll go on and fight Lee Haskins. Haskins defends, I think, in middle of May. He has to fight him within 90 days. Stewie Hall gets another shot at a world title. And listen, he deserves it. He's a credit to the sport. And a wonderful, wonderful fight in there from both men.
Well done. Thank you.